Oh, most gracious and holy Father, in the name of Jesus, oh Lord, we thank you for today. Lord, we thank you for each and every one that is listening to me under the sound of my voice. Oh God, move by your spirit on today's broadcast. Touch the lives of the listeners. Touch my life. Touch each and every person, God, who has their part in making this radio talk show for what it is. Lord, I thank you, Father, for the radio stations, Father. Lord, I thank you for each and every podcast platforms, Father. Lord, every producer, God. Lord, move on their behalf, move in their lives, Father. Lord, I just thank you. I lift your name on high. I glory and I magnify your name, because it is in you that we move, live, and have our being. It is in Jesus' name that we pray. Amen. Y'all! I'm going to be honest with you. Starting off, it was a great time to return. Ended up not being so great. Then it being great. Now it's not being so great. Roller coaster already. Let's get started. We'll talk. It is time for an all new broadcast of the RH3 show. Let's get it. Y'all know how we do. Come on here.
And now we're pleased to bring you our feature presentation.
That's from sinner to saint. As winners we can't live by the picture they paint, because they know that all their inner is tainted. So we must live out our lives with a sense of restraint, which means to our living we ain't. We are controlled by the flesh, we're defeated in sway, and pray without a quitter's complaint. And we can
what it do, family? What's going on, y'all? Hey, what? I'm about to say so. I'm about to be like, what Cardi B say, what's poppin'? What's going on, y'all? What's up? What's up? Y'all might not know me. Y'all might not know me. Okay, well, allow me and wait a minute. Well, allow me to reintroduce myself. My name is Ho. No, it ain't Ho. What's going on, y'all? This your boy Red, host of the RH3 show. Welcome to another great day, another great hour, another great show. Right here on wherever you happen to be listening to me on. Welcome to another great show. Welcome to another great show, another great hour, another great time, y'all. It's been a very long time, and we have so much ground to cover. So much ground to cover. And y'all may think like, well, you were on another station. You were on your podcast platforms. Well, those were pre-recorded as well. And so those were exclusive broadcasts. They were new, but they were exclusives, and they were on the podcast platforms, and I just shared them. And so y'all will get them at a later time, and I'll tell y'all about that time too. So it's a lot. I told y'all today, Monday, big announcements. A lot has been going on, even something that I found out on yesterday, and I was devastated, and it kind of hurt me, and it almost as if I was dealing with it myself, but, you know, I'm not. But hold on. Before we get started, it's time for the kitchen table talk, all right? Time for the kitchen table talk, so let's get started.
right, pull up a chair. Let's have a conversation. It's time for our Kitchen Table Talk.
All right, y'all. It's time for the Kitchen Table Talk. Last time we here at various radio stations, various shows, last time we all talked was the week of Thanksgiving. And y'all, I'm gonna tell y'all something. I'm going to sincerely apologize because my show on that day was it was crazy. It was really crazy. Because I was supposed to come on that Tuesday, and I didn't come on that Wednesday for the rest of the week and up until today. And that was with all of the show, with all the platforms that I was on, and all the stations that I was on. And I was like, you know what? Let me just take a break. Let me just take a break, because I need it. And we all hear the Kitchen Table Talk. And look, y'all, Kitchen Table Talk today is going to be mixed with a lot of things. Going to be mixed with a lot of things, including Inside Scoop of Red. Because we got a lot to cover. A lot to cover, a lot to talk about, a lot to discuss. And so, yeah. A lot to talk about, a lot to cover. And so I said I needed this break. And y'all, the break for one station was supposed to last up until March. But you know, hey, that didn't last until about a week ago. Another station break was supposed, well, it really didn't, really, we really didn't know. And then it got a date for December 17th. Then it got another date for today. And so, well, I know it got another date for last Friday. And so, I'm like, okay. And so, I was going to come back on that Friday, but I'm like, wait a minute. No, I need to rest, continue to rest. Because y'all, one day last week, and if y'all saw my Instagram pages, y'all know that I had my humidifier. I took a picture of my humidifier, then I took a picture of my humidifier, inhaler, the nasal inhaler attachment that's on my humidifier. Y'all, one day last week. And to get your mind at ease, I'm everywhere I go, I always take my mask. So it doesn't have anything to deal with COVID. Doesn't. But one day last week, it was rainy and it was so cold outside. Instead of turning my heat down, excuse me, I slept with no shirt on. And I slept with my window up. And plus, I still had the heat down. Woke up that next day congested, tired, exhausted. I was like that for a couple days. And I'm still like this because, you know, hey, last night I had my humidifier going. And I'm still having my humidifier going and it lit were off and on until, you know, the spring, just to clear the air. Then I'm going to play, well, I have it in my bedroom, you know, and then I'm going to put it in the other room just to clear the air. But, yeah. So I was just all congested and broken up and exhausted. And then on Thursday, I slept off and on all day. And then Friday, when I got home from my regular job, I slept from like, when I came home, I slept from like 5:30 off and on. I got up at like 8:20. I watched a movie on, it's like a little drama show. It's about Moses or whatever. I love it. and it reenacts a whole bunch of Bible scenes on the Living Faith app. Love that show, by the way. Love it. And I watched that for a bit. Then I went back to sleeping. I was off and on heavy sleeping until about 8:30 Saturday morning. This past Saturday morning. And so, yeah. But a lot of things been going on, y'all. A lot of things. And recently, well, let's go on continue with this break thing. Because, and y'all remember, dial it back. Y'all remember whenever I was telling y'all that I had some stuff that I had to tell y'all that, I had to let some key pertinent people know, you know, whatever. I let the last person know on Saturday. And so now is the time that I need to let you all know because, I'm going to be taking if all is well, I'm going to be taking a length of time off of radio, but either I'm a prep new shows or prep shows, or y'all going to get encore shows. And when I say encore shows, I need y'all here. Reason being is because I've been in this game. I've been in radio for 5 years. Y'all have not heard all 5 year worth of episodes. So it's still like y'all getting new shows. And so that was the main reason why I took the break, because I needed the break. So that was fine by me, you know, for whatever reason. And so it was just like a vacation. And so people was asking me, well, Red, did you get off one station? Red, did you quit one station? Did you walk away from the station? No, I took a break. It was presented to me and I took it. I snatched it. And y'all, with this return of me on today, trust and believe, the past Red is not the same as this Red. Reason being is because it's going to be the same dude, going to be the same information, but, you know, I'm coming to you straightforward, you know. It's going to be even more. It's going to be even more real, raw, straight to the point, all from a Christian male perspective. You know, like I said during the summer break, real talk, real conversation, real life, 2.0. You know, and I took a break because I needed it, and I was doing a lot. And so even the producers and the execs could tell you, some days I was coming in here late. Some days, you know, even when I pre-prepped the show, some days that I wasn't, you know, quote unquote live or whatever, I would send in, you know, broadcasts, and I would just be sending it in as soon as the top of the hour drop come in. Reason being because I was at my other job, you know, trying to email it in, you know, just emailing it in, not doing the work at another job. I'm just saying emailing it in. And at that time, internet would be messing up. And so that would, you know, delay it. And so it really wasn't my fault, because I already had the show done or whatever. I was just emailing it, and the Wi-Fi was crazy ridiculous. And so mind you I was doing the show, mind you I'm a jewelry consultant, mind you I'm a dad of a 20-year-old, mind you that I am a brother of 5 siblings, one younger than I am, and the rest are 4 girls older than me. And so dealing with these 4 older sisters who Well, my mom's two daughters, they live out of state, and so I am the communicator between them two, and you know, giving them reports and making sure mama's straight. And of course, my mother, she works, but. And then, you know, they, you know, grilling me, mama, she doing good, she working, you know, what she been up to, da 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 da, and whatever. And me, being I wouldn't say full time minister, but an active associate minister at my church, and, being the president of our media and broadcast ministry department, and then me trying to maintain a love life, and it was just a lot. And so I'm being perfectly honest with you, y'all, and I'm being, you know, full-fledged, straightforward. And so, hey, it was just that. And so, you know, I during my break or whatever, it was a, what kind of break? Let's see here. Thanksgiving was on that Thursday, the 26th. And so, we've been gone for about, what, 2.5? No, we've been gone for, what, 3 weeks? And so, during that time, I think, like, okay, I'm coming back for throttle, for one. Two, coming back for, if I have to take a break, I just have to take a break. If y'all got to get the best stuff, you got to get the best stuff. But I'm going to give it to you real raw, straight to the point. I'm going to give y'all something from the archives or whatever, and make sure that my people are, you know, quote unquote, putting up quotes, fed or whatever. Make sure y'all get a good broadcast. And I want to keep the same people. So, you know, listeners, I, you know, need your help to push, because I come on here each and every day for an hour to give y'all a great show and give it to you real raw, straight to the point. And so, you know, some people get upset with me, you know, because of my opinion. Hey, it is what it is, people, you know. That right there, I mean, I care about it, but, you know, hey, I mean, I come on here an hour, and, you know, I do my thing for an hour. I love to entertain you all, and I love doing what I love to do for the people I love. You, my co-hosts, my chances, and my day one family. I just give God all the glory and all the honor and all the praises for you all. I really do. And so I'm glad to have this time with you all, you know? And so each and every day, whenever I hear, dun, I know I got a praise, I be rocking it out. Do you hear me? And whenever the applause come on, it's on. I give it 120%. I give it back to God. I'm like, God, okay, this thing is yours each and every day. Each and every time I listen to it on the podcast platform. Each and every time somebody else listen to it. I give it back to you. And so, yeah. I give it back to you. I give it back to you fully, totally back to you. And so, hey, that's what I do. And that's my break. And so what is the break? Okay, mid-January, I have an appointment, not really a consultation, but a follow-up. And then that's whenever I'll give the date. The break will be sometime in February. But I'm having an operation. And so that operation will set me back for probably about 2 weeks, maybe. And so, you know, I'll let y'all know then, but we're going to rock it and ride it out until February. But I'll keep y'all posted, and we'll, you know, hey, we're going to keep doing our thing until then. And so, yeah. And that's all I'm going to say about it until February. If we all still here, heaven forbids, you know. And so, hey, Nina Taylor, y'all, she left us, y'all. She left us. Nina Taylor is not here. But we have a plethora of gospel news that we can pull from, general gospel news. And so, yeah. She left us some of that. And so here's what we got planned for the rest of the show. I'm going to continue on with our conversation. All right. After the commercial break, we're going to take a quick break. And then I'm going to pull one of those general gospel news reports. And then I'm going to continue on because we got some breaking news that happened. And I kind of sensed it. Now that I pieced it together, like, oh, okay, so that was why. And then, you know, that was why. But we'll talk. And so I'll talk to y'all after Nina. She's on vacation. She won't be back until I think about first part of January, first of the new year. And so it'll be just be us. And some days I won't play a general gospel news. But yeah, more of the RH3 show is coming up next. I still got more to talk.
Have you ever thought about starting your own podcast? When I was trying to get this podcast off the ground, I had a lot of questions. How do I record an episode? How do I get my show into all the apps that people like to listen to? And how do I make money from my podcast? The answer to every one of these questions is so very easy and simple. It is Anchor, y'all. It's Anchor. Anchor is a one-stop shop for recording, hosting, and distributing your podcast. Best of all, it is 100% and ridiculously easy to use. Most of all, it is free. And now, y'all, Anchor can match you with great sponsors who want to advertise on your podcast. That means you can get paid right away. In fact, that's what I'm doing right now by reading this ad here. I use Anchor for my radio broadcast as another branch to advertise and promote my episodes and my show that stems right from YouTube. And what I like about Anchor is that it distributes all to many platforms, as well as it has an in-depth statistics to where you can see how your podcast is doing. That's cool, right? I love it. So if you always wanted to start your podcast and make money doing it, please go to anchor.fm/start to join me and the diverse community of podcasters who are already using Anchor. That's anchor.fm/start. My name is Red, and I'm the host of the RH3 show. I cannot wait to hear your podcast.
Talk to you all about, all right? Be back in a moment.
Here we go! From all of us here at the RH3 show, we would like to wish each and every one of you a very Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. Always remember that Jesus is the reason for the season, and wise men and women do still seek him. Have a blessed and prosperous New Year.
Peace on earth and mercy mild.
Sometimes you get a pre-show, sometimes you get an after show, but you do get behind the scenes of the RH3 show, and sometimes I may give you transparency and let you follow me. I am a personal life. Follow me on Instagram at the RH3 show. I check my stories out. Check my page out. Follow me today.
We can't live by the picture they paint, because they know that all the inner is changed, so we must live out our lives with a sense of restraint.
Gotta to catch up on the news regarding politics, or if you want to know news about the TV, movies, sports, and or the music industry, be it if it's in gospel or any other entertainment genre, well, it is time for the Inside Scoop of the Rufus right here on the RH3 Show.
Hi, I'm Nina Taylor, and here is your gospel news. Contemporary gospel and contemporary Christian music artist Jermaine Dolly, born and raised in Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. He grew up in the church playing piano and drums and singing at a very young age. He attended Westchester University and sang with the school's choir. While there, he also performed in the group Praise One. When that group opened for Ty Tribbett, Dolly impressed Tribbett so much that he was asked to tour as a background vocalist for the major gospel star. Dolly eventually recorded with Ty Tribbett. Also as a solo artist, Dolly debuted in 2015 with his single, You. In early 2017, he issued Come and Knock on My Door, the first single from his debut solo album, The Dolly Express, which followed a year later in May. Able to bring a crowd to their feet with their powerful preaching and performances, evangelist singer Ja'Kalen Carr was only 15 years old when she first broke onto the Billboard Top Gospel 200. The West Memphis-based gospel artist made her debut in 2010 with her EP, God Has a Promise Over Your Life. In 2012, she had a hit with the single Greater Is Coming, which became the album climbed into the Billboard Top 200 and debuted at number 3 on Billboard's Top Gospel Albums charts. Her 2014 sophomore release, It's Gonna Happen, peaked at number 9. And in 2016, You're Bigger, the lead single from her forthcoming third album, The Life Project. Her fourth project, One Nation Under God, came out in early 2018. Tripp Lee, who was born William Lee Barfield III, was born and raised in Dallas, Texas. As a young boy, Lee had dreams of being a professional athlete or a famous rapper. Upon giving his life to Christ at the age of 14, his focus changed from fortune, fame, and women to serving and ministering the gospel. One day, he just decided only to do Christian hip-hop. Rappers like Ambassador and Da Truth helped provide a model for how he should develop his rapping skills. In 2004, Lee met Lecrae at a concert. His debut album, If Only They Knew, was released a few days after he graduated from high school. That same year, he was also featured on the Dove Award-nominated Jesus Music with label mate Lecrae. His second album, 2020, was released in 2008. His third album, Between Two Worlds, Lee offered a collection of reflections on life in a fallen world. Alexis Marie Nuklos Allen, better known as Lexi, born October 2nd in Columbus, Ohio. She is an American gospel singer, actress, comedian, and gospel artist. Known as Lexi, she grew up in her grandfather's church, the only child of Dr. Ruby Nuklos, and was educated at Browser High School in Toledo and then Bowling Green State University. Lexi began singing and sang backup for Gerald Levert, Vanessa Bell Armstrong, and Fred Hammond. After the release of her album, Call Her Lexi, in 1990, she stepped away from the music business to begin studying and working as a teacher before renewing her singing career a decade later. Lexi's late husband, former music producer Michael Allen, Lexi captured the attention of former boxing champion Evander Holyfield, who had his own record label, Real Deal Records. While signed to Holyfield's label, Lexi released Lexi and That's the Way It Is in 2002, A Praise in the Valley in 2004, and What Heaven Hears in 2005. Her 2004 album earned her a Stellar Gospel Music Award nomination. In 2006, Lexi became the public face of the Word Network, where she presents the regular program, The Word Network Church with Lexi. She also hosts her own show, The Lexi Show. Here's your Billboard Top 10 Gospel Songs in the Country. Number 10, Tasha Cobbs Leonard, I'm Getting Ready. Number 9, Brian Courtney Wilson, A Great Work. 8, B.B. Winans, He Promised Me. 7, Jonathan McReynolds, Not Lucky, I'm Loved. 6, Ja'Kalen Carr, You Will Win. 5, Tamela Mann, Through It All. 4, J.J. Harrison and Youthful joyful praise. No reason to fear. Number 3, Jermaine Dolly, Serve. Number 2, Todd Delaney, Your Great Name. And number 1, Corin Hawthorne with Won't He Do It. Well, that's your Billboard Top 10 Songs and your gospel news. I'm Nina Taylor. Let's get back to more great gospel music on this great station.
All right. Thank you, Nina Taylor, for your general portion, whether it's general or new or whatever, of the Inside Scoop with Red segment, the gospel news portion. Thank you so very much. We have a first look. Well, we showed the first look over the weekend since Thursday. First look of the new movie, Wendy Williams, the movie, which is coming out on January the 30th, 2021. And we played that on our Instagram and our Twitter and our Facebook page. But I have it audio for you all now to take a listen. So take a listen, y'all.
It's your girl, Wendy Williams, on the mic. I am here to stay. Wendy Williams is not going anywhere. I'm going to come in like a hurricane. So, Whitney, are you still using drugs?
Who wants to give you a talk show?
Millions of people turn on the radio to listen to me.
You're the star.
I am going to tell it like it is. I'm becoming a real business. And I've been trusting you to take care of all of them.
You're self-indulgent. You're narcissistic. You got a coke habit.
He's having a baby with her. Before I had you, I had me. And not you nor anyone else have the power to take away my gifts. I'm gonna bring the heat. Let it go up in flames.
I will turn this city out.
A Lifetime original movie, Wendy Williams, premieres Saturday, January 30th at 8. Only on Lifetime.
I love it. I love it. And so, y'all, I'm trying to get Darren on the show. And then mid-January, I want to have Sierra or Morocco, who plays Kelvin, on the show to come and talk about the movie. And so, yeah, keep us in prayer. And if you all would, I think it's Darren Grant. I think it's director Darren Grant, but anyway, y'all see it on my page and just at him. Use the hashtag and at, y'all see it on my page or whatever. And, y'all know what to do. Y'all done it before, but it didn't work because some people didn't follow directions. But, yeah, and let's try to get him on there because we want to talk to him. All right. Speaking of Wendy Williams, y'all, this is what I was talking about in the introduction. And it almost, and it's still getting me teary-eyed because y'all know how for the past couple of weeks I've been conversing and talking back with Tommy in regards to having him come on the show. And y'all know my 18 to 19 year following of Wendy and whatever, but I want to report that their mom has passed away, and Miss Shirley has been a even staple to Wendy's career. Shirley has been a staple to Wendy's career, and I've heard her on the radio. Hi, this is Wendy's. Hi, this is Wendy's mom, and this is Wendy's dad, and we both want to know how you doing. If y'all remember her on radio, that was something that her mom and dad would say on the radio, and her mom and dad would say on the radio, and she really was very, very, very proud of Wendy, and she was very proud of her children, all of them, And so, you know, Tommy as a school teacher, Wanda as the lawyer, they were very educated. Very educated. And when I heard her passing on yesterday, then I found out that she had actually passed, well, today been 4 days ago, but yesterday was 3 days ago. It just hurt me to the core because they, you know, it was just like family. I knew Wendy, you know, from the radio, and, you know, it was before she was, well, she was still big then, but it was before she was major like she is now. And then, of course, through Tommy now, you know, him talking about his parents and him going to stay with his mom and dad. And it was just tough. It was like I lost Aunt Shirley. And so it really broke my heart because they are a, when I say they close. And it is very crazy how their family dynamic is, because the story of Wendy and how she was born and how she was brought into this world, you know, it seemed like it is the same way with her nephew's daughter, Bella. You know, Bella was born this year, and Miss Shirley passed. When Wendy was born, a couple months later, her grandmother passed. And so it's just devastating. It's sad. It's very sad. And so here is a clip from the Wendy Williams show that, you know, I want to play and you know, hey, just big shout out to Miss Shirley. You know, she was well loved, very well loved, very well loved. And so, yeah, y'all, I'm gonna read one Ask Red letter, and then I know a lot of y'all, due to my emergency break that I was just like, okay, you know what, to heck with it. Oh, by the way, I forgot to mention to y'all how my Thanksgiving went, because y'all, some of y'all listened to me on the podcast platform during the Thanksgiving break. Some of y'all didn't, but Thanksgiving went great. It was okay, but I was kind of a little devastated that week, and I let some things slip away, and I'm still paying the price for it. But you know, I hope I'm making it right. I hope I'm making it right, because my love for you know, whatever, is still there. But anyway, I hope I'm making it right. But I spent Thanksgiving with my baby, my son. And he just lighted up my day that day whenever he, you know, I came into his house, and then I went in there to talk to his mother and her boyfriend. And he came in the room because he didn't know I was coming. My son didn't. And so when he heard me in there talking, it was just as if, you know, he was lit up and was like, hey, man, I didn't know you were coming. And I was just in there in the room and I heard your voice. Oh God, that just, yeah, that tore me up. But I stood up and gave him a hug, because it's been a minute since I saw my baby. And so I shook his hand and I gave him a hug, and I told him, I said, yep, I'm here for you. And so he was very happy to see his pops, very happy to see him. And so I stayed with him all night, and not throughout the night, but all night. And then he had the pleasure to take in his, well, was it that same night? Who took me home the other night? Oh, my niece's mother. But that Thursday he drove me back home, and that was it. And so I really enjoyed spending time with my cat. I really did. That, from that week, you know, and deciding to take a break and all of that, it was just, you know what, I was just overdone.
overdone.
And so I'm like, okay. And so I spent, and y'all saw the pictures. And that picture with that I posted, that was Thanksgiving night, or was it the night after? That was the night. Thanksgiving was Thursday. That was that Saturday. I went back over there that Saturday, and so because his aunt was having a brain surgery, and so we went to I went back over there to celebrate her, and so that was that. But yeah, spent that with him, and so he always bring joy to my life, and I celebrate my son. Celebrate him. God gave me a gift when he gave me him, and so, you know, he is not a saint. He don't always do things right, and so, but when he do, I just honor and thank God for him, you know. You know, and so he was the first one that sent me a happy Thanksgiving message. Happy Thanksgiving, Pops. I'm so thankful for you, and it's just good to do right and to do right by your children and see the fruits of your labor. See your fruits of your, and that's what I, you know, and I'm glad this turned into a real talk with Red discussion, because I haven't talked to y'all in a while. But fathers, you know, men, do right by your children. Do right by your children, and you will see the fruits of your labor. We talk about this all the time. Do right by your children. In the street terms, do right by your chaps. And you will see it. And sometimes I can understand why, you know, some kids don't want to be bothered with you. I can see why. Because you're not doing right by them. And one thing that I hate, and I'm going to say this and keep it moving, because I'm going to read a letter and then I want to re-air a segment. But, I had this one friend, and I really didn't understand, and I still don't understand the disrespect on her end, but I totally did understand why, you know, let me rephrase that. I don't understand the disrespect on, you know, why she continue it on her end, but I understand, you know, some of it. And in other words, I don't understand why he do what he do, but I can understand her response, but I don't understand why the continuation of it. Get to the point, Red. Make it sense. Okay, since you asked, I will. He has other children. He treats the other children better than he treats, you know, his first set of children. Two. That don't make no sense. That ain't hot. No. Do right by your kids. I hate saying kids. Do right by your children, fathers. Because I tell you what, it was one time that whenever I first started get to know the young lady that I want to talk to now, and I was telling my son, well, man, babe, I don't call him babe. I don't think this is going to work out. He's like, well, Pops, just pray and pray that it will. I got faith it will. Well, I hope so. Well, I know so. I got faith. And I said, well, I'm glad that you do. And he said, yeah, I learned it from you. I learned it from the best. Come on. We got to instill core great values into our children. We got to do that. Oh, yeah. By the way, if y'all hear water bubbling or whatever and some noise in the background, I brought this humidifier with me, and so I got it going. But, We got to. And so that's all I have for you right now. So more of the RH3 show is coming up next. I'm going to read this quick ask red letter for you in just a moment. All right, stay tuned.
Here's your Be Positive message for today. Be bold, take risks, live life freely, lead by example, trust your gut, say what you feel, mean what you say, express gratitude, believe in your power, exceed your expectations, dance the night away, skip down the street, don't take no for an answer, be yourself, don't look back. These are inspirational words for you to live by.
The RH3 Show. For more about the broadcast, please visit therh3show.com.
The following content of this episode of the RH3
Show. What I just told you, that's how I felt. If that's how I felt. If I wanted to say that, I would have wrote it.
Well, you implied that.
I said what I said.
Need some advice? Got a question for me? Or you just need help solving a problem? It is the Ask Rufus Letters right here on the RH3 Show.
All right, you all, it is the Ask Rufus Letter segment right here on the RH3 Show. And you guys, listen, two things I want to take time to say. I always say this all the time. Fellas, don't be afraid to drop tears, all right? Don't hold it in. Don't hold it in. And two, like I was telling you all about the crazy part of the windy dynamic, I told you all about, you know, how, Bella was born and Miss Shirley passed, and that's the same thing that happened with Wendy. And, you know, Wendy was born and the grandmother had passed and all of that. And but, you know, they had Miss Shirley and Mr. Tom had three children, Wanda, Wendy, and Tommy. And so they got three grandchildren. They have Alexandria. They have, the boy named Travis, and they have little Kevin. So they have children. They have two girls and a boy. Grandchildren, they have two boys and a girl. And, you know, I thought that was a coincidence. But anyway, here's today's Ask Red Letter segment. Ask Red Letter, minute or whatever. Here it goes. My boyfriend and I have been together for 6 years now. He knows that I want to start my own, I guess, family, but he has kids from a previous relationship and doesn't want any more. We found out that his oldest is going to have a baby. It's really hard on me. He told me that it's my choice. I either stay and give up having a family or leave and have the chance. But it seems like no matter what I choose, I'm going to lose. I'm so lost on what to do. Anyone have been in this spot, or am I screwed? Well, I kind of been in a spot, but I kind of haven't. But what I will say this is, you can compromise, but don't lower. Don't lower your standard. You can compromise it, but don't lower. Compromise would mean, excuse me, I had to yawn. Sorry, it's been a long day, as y'all know. I told y'all, days, you know, long time short. You have to compromise. Like, for instance, sometimes you have to, I just lost my contract, I mean my concentration, forgot the word I was thinking of, y'all. Oh yeah, I was stuck in on compromising, but compromise. Well, start with lowering your standards. Lowering your standards is if saying, you know, I want a child, but I don't like boys, but I'll take, you know, I'll adopt a boy. That's lowering your standards. If you want to adopt a girl, press for it. Press for it. I want a daughter. I'm going to press for it. I want to adopt a daughter. That's lowering your standard. Compromising. You want children. You would prefer a girl, but it don't matter which one. That's compromising. I want a child. My main focus is getting a child, period. And so, hey, that's that. That is that. And so, going back to this letter, I would say, if you don't want children, dip. Because if that's something that you want to do, don't lower your standard for that. And people always tell me, well, Red, you know, you just got Isaac and, you know, he's not in the home. And some lady's going to wish they was with you, you know, with a man who don't have children in the house and, you know, little small children at that. And blase this, that, and the third, and they gonna wish, you know, they had children with you, and you know, cause you can easily, you know, have children elsewhere, and they up and leave or whatever, and they not taking you as a good man in consideration. Hey, it is what it is. I'm not lowering that. If I want a child, I want a child. I'm not lowering my standards because just to make her happy. Or just because she says she don't want no children. I'll just go leave and find somebody else who do. And so, lady, that's what I would say that you should do. Find somebody who... Now, in plus 6 years? Uh-uh. Like Little Kim says, 6 long years? You know what? Hasta la vista. Bye-bye. Kiss your kids. This is the gangsters. Nah. Peace. I'm out. All right, you guys, that's enough of me rambling and carrying on. What I'm going to do is I played a couple weeks ago my list of those who were, which is now past tense, invited to my Friends in the Head Thanksgiving Day dinner. So I'm going to replay that for you all. And I'll be back with more of the RH3 show, which is coming up next. Be back in a moment. I'll see y'all in just a bit. All right. Peace.
Want a free subscription to be a part of our live listening audience? Download one of the major podcast platforms: Google Podcasts, Google Play Music, Apple Podcasts, iTunes, Spotify, iHeartRadio, Radio Public, and more. And search The RH3 Show and subscribe. You'll get all new content as well as access to previously aired broadcasts to listen to, download, and to share to your contacts. We'd love for you to be a part of our family. Subscribe today.
The RH3 Show. For more about the broadcast, please visit therh3show.com.
They gave it a switch. Our lives were in darkness. They came with a switch. So we don't walk like we used to. Talk like we used to. Call us for honor and he'll do it for you too. Yeah.
I know I gotta raise the bell. Raise the bloody call. They do so it's
Jesus loving you. It sounds crazy, don't it?
Hey, this is Quayle.
This is Isaiah Templeton.
Hey, family, this is Darius Parker.
I'm Nina Taylor from The Gospel News.
Yo, what's going on? It's your boy, Mario J. Brown.
Well, this is Rock River alongside Red.
This is Wincy.
And you are listening to my boy, Red, with the RH3 Show.
And you're listening to 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 the RH3 Show.
Boss of boss. Oh, yes.
Let me tell you what it goes.
Alright, y'all, because of time, I looked back at the clip or the portion of that broadcast, and that broadcast is like 13 minutes, and we got, what, like 10 minutes left of the show, and even on other stations, we got people after us now, and so, I'm gonna have to pull that on tomorrow's show, so, sorry, y'all. Hold on one second. sorry. But I forgot to mention during the Inside Scoop with Red segment, I spoke with Tommy this morning, and y'all, he liked the show. He's been listening on. He's been listening on the YouTube channel, but I haven't been pressing the issue of asking him, have he been listening to the show or whatever? And not only speaking with, you know, Tommy this morning, Wendy, she took it very well this morning. You know, she had a long, probably about 12 to 15 minute conversation and walked down memory lane. Well, not a video presentation, but a talk, you know, about her mother. So she took it pretty well. But Tommy, he finally told me this morning, hey, I've listened, you know, to the show and I'm continue to subscribe and be supportive and, you know, this, that. And so that's my dude, y'all. I really like Tommy and because he's a good dude. He's a good cat. And, you know, I like him and I like I feel like that I know them, but I don't know him personally. But I feel like I know him because, you know, for one, through him and then through Wendy and, you know, they good people, y'all. They are good people. And, you know, that's why I get them. That's why I get them. And I said all of that to say this. Yeah, Miss Shirley, they all are doing well. They all are doing good. She passed over a week ago, and well, she passed last Sunday. She didn't pass yesterday, and she didn't pass 3 days ago, as I thought. And the reason why I say that is because I went on a I just saw comments from 3 days ago of, you know, the loss of the passing, but confirmed it was last Sunday when she passed, and so. You know, they are very positive and they are very, you know, he said he has this time and days to where, you know, he can buckle or whatever, but they are going to live and move and press forward as if Miss Shirley would want them to. And, you know, Miss Shirley, she was a bubbly. If you've seen her, and I'm only talking by what I've seen and what went, you know, to where she been on Wendy's show, because like I said, I don't know them personally, but I've seen to where, you know, how she was on Wendy's show and being a, you know, a staple on there. And she was a very sweet woman. Very sweet woman. And well, she looked as if she was one, because like I said, again, I don't know him personally, but she was a very sweet woman. And and like they say in the, not in the streets, but like they say, yeah, like they say, to know somebody's, or to know somebody of that caliber is to love them. And to know Miss Shirley, you is to love her. And so, you know, if you knew Miss Shirley, you probably loved Miss Shirley. And so that's how, and I loved her. And one of my favorite moments, you know, with Miss Shirley, again, hearing her even on Wendy's radio show back in the day. And also, I'm going to hair up and go because I need to close out today's broadcast. Was an announcement, but also whenever during one of Wendy's after show, during the first part of her season was, whenever Wendy saw, some things that Miss Shirley and Mr. Tom was, had some stuff pulled in the bag. But anyway, I'm conversing on them, and y'all probably know, well, wonder why. It's because, you know, hey, just, you know, big supporters of them. And with Tommy being a friend to the show, this is my support showing support. And if you, you know, want to talk about something else, hey, get your own show, do whatever, talk whatever, however, but I love it, and that's whatever. But anyway, I hope y'all enjoyed today's broadcast, today's show. It was a good one, all right? Know that I love you for real, and always remember to live every day, laugh every moment, and to love God, love yourself, and to love other people beyond words. For more about me or the broadcast, you can visit our website at therh3show.com to send an Ask Red letter. You can send that to askrh3@gmail.com. I am out of here. I'm going back home to rest. And then I am going to get back up so I can prep and go ahead and work on tomorrow's show. Because y'all already know that Tuesdays and Fridays, well, mainly Wednesdays and Fridays are my air days for, you know, this year. Excuse me, I meant Tuesdays and Thursdays are my 2 days for double days, meaning that I do the show live at 1, and then I, as soon as I get off, I pre-record for the second show or whenever the next show is or whatever. And so, yeah, I do that for general reasons. All right, I'll talk to y'all later. I love you all for real, and I'll see you all on tomorrow.
And pray without a foolish complaint, and being able to turn down your dinner at 8. Because the price that he paid for me gave to me my freedom, so I'm not in slavery. Christ made a way for me, grace me, then paid for me. A way back to God through the life that he gave for me.
Peace, party people. See you later.
I'm saying bye-bye.
Good night. Good night.
Here we go.
From all of us here at the RH3 Show, we would like to wish each and every one of you a very Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. Always remember that Jesus is the reason for the season, and wise men and women do still seek him. Have a blessed and prosperous New Year.
Peace on earth and mercy mild.